Hi, and welcome back to Tundra Sounds. Today we are going to take a look at how you can play, record and play back chords with the Tempest by using a MIDI keyboard and a digital audio workstation. So in my case, we are using the Arturia keystep, connecting a MIDI cable from the MIDI out of the keystep to the MIDI in of my audio interface. And my audio interface is a Steinberg UR22MK2. The MIDI out of my audio interface will have a MIDI cable going to the DSI Tempest. And we also have a USB cable from the audio interface to my computer running Logic Pro X. That's my digital audio workstation. So we are connecting all of these units now, and we want to do some changes to the settings so that they will work together perfectly. So you open Logic Pro X and you find this in front of you. You will choose external MIDI because we are controlling the Tempest, which is external, and we are using MIDI to control the sounds of the Tempest. And we're using MIDI channel number 1. In my case, we are using my audio interface Steinberg UR22MK2. In your case, maybe you have a USB cable connected directly to the Tempest, or you are using a USB to MIDI in some way. You will find something else here. You will just find out what to choose. In my case, this is my audio interface. And I will also have to be able to listen to the sounds coming from the Tempest. So I will hit this one and choose input number 2 because I have an audio cable going from the main out to input number 2. And this one, input number 1, is recording my voice as we speak. So input number 2. Hit create. And then I will just name this one MIDI to Tempest plus listen. So I'm going to use this to send MIDI messages to the Tempest, but this will also be able to listen to the Tempest. So when I'm playing now, you will hear one of the sounds that I created on the Tempest. And now we're going to try to record it. But first, I want you to take a look at what I did on the Tempest to achieve this. So hit the system button, hit it again so that the system menu comes up. And as you can see, this here is the first page. System general, and then 1, 2, 3. System MIDI polyphonic keyboard play, and I'm using MIDI synth in channel number 1 and MIDI synth sound A10 because sound bank, let's get out of this sound bank B, sound bank A, and let's listen. It's not this sound, not any of these sounds, but this sound. So A10, as you can see here, A10. Okay, and let's try to record something, because now we can use the Logic sequencer to control this and quantize if we are playing very wrong. Let's play something. Okay, some simple chords here. I will just hit this one, take a look. And as you can see, I have messed up some of the notes here. And I can do something about that. So, there, now it's correct. So this is a way to play chords on the Tempest and actually record the performance on Logic Pro X and be able to listen to it. And now you're going to actually record it, so you will have to create another track. So I will hit the plus button here, and I will hit the audio button here and choose input number 2, and then I will, let's see, use the create button here, and this will be Tempest chords, and I will mute one of them, this one, and hit the record button. So that's one of the ways that you can record, play, edit, play back chords by using Logic Pro X to control the sounds on the Tempest. So it's the MIDI performance that actually is sent to the Tempest and controls the behavior of the Tempest sounds. If you want to do this internally instead of externally, you will have to do some of the workarounds that I have mentioned in another video I did, the 5 chord modes. So try it out. If you liked the video, if you liked my YouTube page, like, subscribe. If you have any questions, put a question below in the comment section. And yeah, see you next time. Bye.